In this video, we will take a look at the life of epiglottis. On the epiglottis, we can recognize two sides, oral and pharyngeal. The most of surface of epiglottis is covered by stratified squamous nonkeratinized epithelium. It's here. Approximately here is a basal membrane of this epithelium. Basal layer with cuboidal or columnar cells which differentiate and move on the surface, and the surface layer contains flattened cells, and the nuclei of these cells are still present. So this is stratified squamous, because this is flattened squamous cells, non-keratinized, with nuclei on the surface layer. So this is the oral side, and another pharyngeal side is lined also by stratified squamous non-keratinized epithelium, but half of this side is lined with pseudostratified ciliated columnar epithelium. Here, you can see this epithelium. Each cell is rests on the basal membrane. Approximately here is a basal membrane, but only some cells reach the free surface. So this is the pseudo-stratified ciliated. Here you can see ciliated apical part of this epithelium, and with goblet cells, but here it's not very good visible. For example, here is goblet cells also here. So this is the surface, and it's epithelium. Here is also surface epithelium, pseudostratified ciliated columnar epithelium, but this is the worse plane of the section. So this is the surface. Beneath the epithelium, we can find lamina propria, loose connective tissue with fat cells, adipose cells, nerve fibers here, small and bigger blood vessels. This is the artery. Also here, it's a smaller branch. And seromucous cells. The darker cells are seros with around nuclei and zymogenic granules in their cytoplasm. So this is the seros cells, and another part of these glands is formed by mucosa cells. Mucosa cells have nuclei on the periphery and a very pale cytoplasm full of the mucosa. So, and here is their duct lined with simple cuboidal epithelium. This is a small duct, and for example, where is it? Here is a bigger duct lined with by a simple columnar epithelium. You can see the duct goes through the lamina propria and open into the surface of epiglottis. So this is the lamina propria with seromucous glands. And the framework of epiglottis is formed by elastic cartilage. Here is an elastic cartilage, which is covered by a perichondrium. Here it's a perichondrium, and another side is also covered by perichondrium. Perichondrium has two layers, a fibrogenic layer approximately here. The fibrogenic layer contains fibroblast, collagen fibers one type, and blood vessels and nerves. And chondrogenic layer of perichondrium contains chondroblast. For example, here, also here, and here. This is the chondrogenic layer of perichondrium, and also in other side, also chondroblast in a chondrogenic layer of perichondrium, and here is a fibrogenic layer of perichondrium. So in the elastic cartilage, you can find chondrocytes here, which is form a small isogenic group, or along chondrocytes. Is located in the lacune, and between the chondrocytes you can find elastic fibers, collagen fibers type 2, and in the matrix of cartilage. The matrix contains glycoproteins, proteoglycans, and a lot of water. So now that's all for the epiglottis. You can find two types of epithelium: stratified squamous nonkeratinized epithelium, which is covered most of the surface of epiglottis, and the second epithelium is pseudostratified columnar ciliated epithelium. Between in this epithelium epithelia you can find stratified columnar epithelium, but it's not here. Beneath the epithelium is a lamina propria with the blood vessels, seromucous cell glands, and fat cells. And the core of the epiglottis is formed by elastic cartilage. So, thank you very much for your attention.